When did you first start voice acting? How did it all begin for you?
I just fell into it. I went on Craigslist to like look at jobs. I saw acting jobs. I was like, oh, acting, that'd be fun. And I booked things. And so then I signed up for LA casting and I saw a voiceover job. I thought, oh, voiceover, that'd be fun. And I booked it and it just kind of all took off from there.
I heard you're also a singer-songwriter as well.
I am.
You are. And you've done like a few songs or based on...
I've heard over 30 out.
You've done 30?
30.
Wow, amazing. And I know you've done quite a few for Hu Tao as well. You've done a special song for Hu Tao.
Yeah, I've done some covers in my character voices, but my starless stuff, my individual stuff, that's like, you know, that stuff I wrote, so it's a little bit more special to me.
That's amazing. Now, what is your inspiration behind some of your songs that you do?
Yeah, my inspiration, I don't know. It's another form of acting for me. I get to create an imaginary world and immerse myself in an imaginary world and create a magical space that's like an alternate reality where I can help, where I can evoke feelings, and maybe it's a cathartic experience for other people. So I don't know. It's just maybe the inspiration is just emotions and fantasy.
Do you enjoy voice acting over games more or actually voice acting from anime?
You know, that's such a tough question. They're both really, really, really special and important to me. I actually adore doing both. So I can't choose a favorite child. Don't make me choose. I would say some dream roles in the future would be a lead in a zombie survival game. Like Last of Us, lead in a vampire series, maybe a Miyazaki film.
Potentially like the new Castlevania that might come out.
Listen, that'd be badass.
That would be wicked.
Can I say badass?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, yeah. We've said it now. It's out there now.
There's no going back.
So yeah, we've done it. We've said it.
Is there any challenging roles that you had to play where you had to get emotionally involved with the character? Like, for example, Rem from Ray Zero, Life in Another World,
yeah,
where she's having that conversation with Subaru.
Yeah.
Which, personally, me, Subaru should have chose Rem.
Listen.
That's my personal grief with it.
Yeah.
But what is your thoughts on that, and how did that make you feel as being that character?
Yeah, so I think part of my typecast is the emotional center of the anime. I mean, Kanao, and like, there's just so much heart in my characters, and it's always like this heartbreaking, sad thing that like where I break people's hearts. That's part of my typecast. So I do tend to do a lot of characters that are extremely emotional. But for challenging roles, I think it's more interesting to talk about Akira from Astral Chain.
Ooh.
I don't know if anybody's ever played that, but that character is, the director wanted her to be as masculine, as manly, as boss as Alex Lee's version of my character. He plays the male twin, I play the female twin, and I don't know if you can tell, but I'm very, very feminine. I identify as a woman. So masculinity is kind of foreign to me. I don't have a lot of that. So that was an extremely, when you talk about challenging roles,
yeah,
that was maybe the most single challenging thing I've ever done in my life. Finding that police officer man on level with Alex Lee was really hard for me, but I did it and it was amazing.
Well, it sounds like you did a great job in it because
sold
a lot, didn't it?
Yeah, when we found it, when we finally got there and Jamie Mortellaro was like, that's it.
Mm.
When I finally found that pocket, it was so rewarding because I fought for it.
Yeah.
So when you're reading a script and you have it in front of you, do you take it for what it is? Do you want to add changes to your scripts? Is there something that you look at and be like, I don't really feel like my character will go this way. Can we change it and go a different direction? Are you more hands-on with your script, or are you, do you know what, I take it as it comes?
So generally we are 100% bound to the script, especially for anime. There are rare cases where we get to influence things, have a voice, and maybe suggest some things. it depends on the director that you're working with. It depends on the project. And I know which ones those are, which I can speak up, and which other ones you just don't say anything. And there's, if I don't really identify with something and I'm confused about, you know, why would my character do this, I ask the director to give me something to work off of. Has anybody seen Soma Spider So What? Okay, so that one, I lived with Kumiko on that show for maybe like, I don't even know, like 6 months, 5 days a week. I went on a journey with that character. That character is like in my heart. And that character was mine, and I had a lot of creative freedom to suggest script changes, which never, ever, ever happens in anime. So it was really exciting. And there was one line, maybe second, third of the show, where she's like, oh no, I started a war. And I was like, David, I have an idea. He's like, this is your character, just go for it. And I was like, so excited. So I hear the beep, 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 and I go, oops, I started a war. And he like just died laughing, and it stayed in the show. So I got to put like a Britney Spears song in the show. I was so happy.
That's brilliant.
Isn't it
actually brilliant?
Come on now, that's like epic, right?
That's actually really good.
Isn't that great?
That's brilliant.
I was like, this is my moment, guys. Step aside, this is my moment. I will say also, in the newest Hu Tao release, there was a line, and we did get it approved originally, but then I saw a clip and they made it the original one. But she says in the line, like, Backstreet Poet. So I was like, Chris, I have a crazy idea. He's like, yeah, go for it. And I said, like, the first part of the line, I don't remember what it is. It's like, you're with the, and I was like, Backstreet's Poet, all right. So it was like Backstreet Boys. And originally we were all like, oh my God, can we do it? Will they keep it? Is MiHoYo okay with this? And originally in the email, they approved it. So I was so excited for it to come out, for everybody here, because I got Backstreet Boys in there, but they used the one where I'm not singing, so I'm like really sad.
Oh, boo.
It was amazing.
Wow.
Backstreet Boys are better than NSYNC.
The success of video games being turned into live action, like we saw The Last of Us on HBO, and the Mario film, if Genshin ever got made into a live action, would you want to reprise your role in live action, or who would you cast?
Are you even kidding me? Yeah. Are you kidding me? I'd dye my hair brown and everything. Let's go. When do we film? When do we start? I'm ready.
I know you wanted to be a fashion designer and you went to LA, but I just wanted to know where it went wrong for you and how it made you feel.
Yeah, it's so interesting. That's such an interesting question, because when I originally decided to go to school for fashion and I was in school for fashion, it did feel very aligned. Everything felt right and I saw no issues and I thought, yeah, this is, I made the right choice. I feel good. This is fulfilling me and I'm going to do this. But when I went to LA, I paid a seamstress to like make one coat, and I was like trying to sew stuff in my apartment, and everything just started feeling very difficult. Like, it just didn't feel easy. It felt like I was like fighting against me. And then when I got one day at a fashion firm, they had me sitting on a computer doing CAD work, computer aided design, and it felt so soul sucking, and it felt like really just, it didn't feel right. And I remember crying in my car at lunchtime, and I just knew, I was like, this is not it. Something is really wrong. It shouldn't feel like a struggle. It shouldn't feel this difficult. I'm really in touch with my own energy, and I just knew it wasn't right. And so I'm very stubborn. You can't make me do anything I don't want to do. So I was brave and I quit right away. And I was like, well, gotta figure out what I'm supposed to do here, because fashion ain't it. Just follow your heart and follow your gut. Your gut and your instincts are so smart, and it'll never lead you astray. You'll know. Pay attention to your heart over your head. Your head will talk you out of things. Try to listen to your heart and what your instincts are trying to tell you.
I usually watch the Genshin Impact Among Us games. I quite like the live streams. And I just wanted to ask you how those games and the chance just to interact outside with other cast members, how it like affected your relationships with them.
Yeah, it's really fun. The voiceover community is like one giant family. It's really nice because a lot of them are my friends, you know, all the way from acquaintances to like soul sister status, depending on the person, or, you know, soul sibling. So it's really, really lovely. And we don't really get to record with each other. It's the dream too, but it's not cost effective for projects. So getting to hang out in any form with my castmates is always so fun and delightful.
Remember Troy Baker?
Yeah.
You remember when you did Catherine Full Body as Rin?
Yeah, yeah.
What was it like? Wasn't it great working with someone who's a legend?
I mean, so we go back to what I was just mentioning, where we don't get to work with the other castmates, which kind of sucks. But I never got to work with Troy in the booth, but getting to be in a game with Troy and Laura and Michelle, all absolute legends, is truly like, I will always geek out about that, and it will always be a bucket list, like, oh my God, I was a lead in a video game with the Laura Bailey, the Troy Baker, the Michelle Ruff. That will always be a very, very special game to me. Very.
I just wanted to say if you like Mario Brothers.
If I like Mario Brothers? I love the Mario Brothers games. I haven't played any in a while. I have a lot of catching up to do with video games. There's not enough time in the day to do everything. But yeah, I love Mario.
She loves Mario. Woohoo!
Yay! Oh, and fun little revisiting. In Soma Spider So What, there's a lot of pop culture references. Very purposeful. The script is insanely intelligent. There is a line in Soma Spider So What where Kumiko says, "Let's a go." So I got to do one of Mario's lines in that show, which was like a nice little fun moment for me.
What got you into voice acting?
What got me into it?
Yeah.
It's really funny because when I grew up, I was very, very, very creative. It sounds like, oh, out of nowhere, I just kind of went into acting with no prior experience. I never did theater or anything, but when I was growing up, I would always come up with movies, short films, plays, short stories, songs, concerts, and I would put on endless shows. My mom always had the video camera on me. So even though I just kind of like after fashion went on Craigslist and discovered acting again, it was always kind of there. But yeah, I kind of fell into it, but then I didn't fall into it. But yeah, hope that makes sense. I guess it depends on how you define drama, but I would say I just enjoy immersing myself in imaginary worlds, imaginary fantasy, alternate realities. So I enjoy watching TV and movies. I enjoy playing video games. I enjoy listening to music, and I enjoy acting, and I enjoy creating my own imaginary worlds.
When you were voicing Rem in ReZero, at the start of the anime, your character hated Subaru, right?
Yeah.
But as the anime progressed, you got closer and closer to him. Was that weird switching from hating him and wanting to kill him to being like his biggest supporter?
Was it a weird transition from hating Subaru to then being loving towards him?
No, not at all. In the story, it made complete sense. I'm just immersing myself in the present and like using my imagination. And in the story, she started to have feelings for him, and it just kind of made sense to me.
Genshin, because
I used to play Genshin. I gave up at AR14. I just so much grinding, and I'm a more of a zombie girl. I like first person shooters. Or shooters in general. So, yeah, it's just so much. But it seemed just so, like, intense trying to catch up to everybody else. I started so late, so I kind of just gave up.
Did you pick Aether or Lumine?
Did I what?
Did you pick Aether or Lumi?
Did you pick the boy or the girl from Genshin Impact?
For what?
For like the main characters, the traveler.
Oh. I guess girl? I don't even remember.
She don't remember. One more, yeah? We'll do one more and then I can find someone else quickly.
What was the luckiest pull you ever got?
What was the luckiest pull you ever got, if you can remember?
The echo's killing me. What?
The luckiest pull that you got from like Genshin Impact.
The luck is pull. Wait, say it one more time.
The luckiest pull. So
luckiest,
you know, when
pull.
You, yeah.
Oh, I never pulled on Genshin. I started out with Hu Tao with the staff. My mod got her for me. I never pulled on Genshin, actually.
Hu Tao was really known for her Hilly Chill song, and I was wondering if you could sing it for us.
Oh, the Hilly Chill song.
Oh, asking me to do this Hilly Chill
the
song?
The Hilly Chill song.
I will make you all a deal. I will do the Hilly Churl song if y'all get up and do it with me, and if I can film it and we post it on TikTok.
Yes.
Yes.
Y'all ready?
Everyone up, ready? Up, up. Let's get 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 up. Come on, guys. We want some energy in the situation. We want some energy here. Let's get up and let's start singing this song. Let's go.
Okay.
You ready?
Let's do it. 3, 2, 1. Silly Churl, a Billy Churl. Yeah. Silly Hilly Billy Churl. Woo!
Wonderful!